Hi, it's Patrick Hutzel from Intensive Care at Home, where we provide tailor-made solutions for long-term ventilated adults and children with tracheostomies by improving their quality of life, and where we also provide tailor-made solutions to hospitals and intensive care units to save money and resources whilst providing quality care. In last week's blog, I talked about what is long-term home ventilation. You can check out last week's blog by clicking on the link below this video. In this week's blog, I want to answer another question that we get quite frequently, which is, can you live on a ventilator and tracheostomy with a good quality of life? So let's look at this in more detail. So more and more patients in intensive care, adults and children, survive complicated critical illnesses and hence lengthy stays in intensive care and mechanical ventilation with tracheostomies. Some of those adults and children can be successfully weaned off ventilation and tracheostomies, and others can't. For some adults and children, mechanical ventilation and tracheostomies are simply a bridge to get them better, weaned off both devices, and then they move on to their path of recovery without life support. For others, mechanical ventilation and tracheostomy are an issue they need to deal with long-term and beyond intensive care or ICU. If that's the case, the question inevitably comes up if one can live on a ventilator and tracheostomy with a good quality of life long-term. The answer to it is quite simple, and we know from our clients that it's a clear yes, they can live with a good quality of life. So picture yourself or your loved one in intensive care or in LTAC, long-term acute care, for our US readers and clients, with a ventilator and tracheostomy, and you or your loved one are unable to be weaned off ventilation, or it may take much longer than anticipated. You or your loved one would not have any quality of life in an institution, such as hospital intensive care unit or LTAC, but you can certainly have a good quality of life at home with 24/7 professional and highly skilled intensive care nurses coming to your home. And those nurses are familiar with ventilation and tracheostomy, as well as they are familiar with the unique and special needs of clients at home on ventilation with tracheostomies. The unique skill set of having the combination of both intensive care experience and having experience in a community setting is that, number one, intensive care nursing skills, i.e. ventilation, tracheostomy skills and years of training and exposure to patients on life support. That's unique in and of itself. And number two, those nurses, our nurses, have the sensitivity of working in a unique and highly sensitive home care environment. And therefore, that combination enables our ventilated and tracheostomized clients to live a good quality of life in a home and family environment. Most of our clients live an active social life, with our pediatric clients in particular going to school on a daily basis. For our adult clients, the focus is more on being surrounded by their loved ones and spending time with their families at home, rather than living in intensive care or LTAC for an indefinite and prolonged period. Mechanical ventilation and tracheostomies requires the specialist skills and expertise of intensive care nurses with a minimum of 2 years ICU experience, and ideally with a postgraduate critical care certificate or diploma. Our intensive care nurses have an average of 8 years hospital ICU or pediatric ICU experience, and they also have the sensitivity and social skills to operate in a highly sensitive home care environment. We are employing hundreds of years of ICU and pediatric ICU experience in our service with our intensive care nurses, and therefore we are able to leverage this wealth of skills, knowledge, professionalism, and expertise in the community to the benefits of our clients and other stakeholders. By continuing the specialist treatment and therapy at home when it comes to mechanical ventilation and tracheostomies, it also simply improves the quality of life for our clients and their families. If your loved one is stuck in intensive care or LTAC for months or sometimes even years because of ventilation dependency and tracheostomy, you are stuck in the environment too. And you and your family have most likely put your lives on hold too. You may or may not be able to work or produce an income. And you may not be able to look after significant others in your family, such as your spouse, your children, parents, etc. The consequences of having a loved one on a ventilator with tracheostomy and therefore on life support are massive, especially if you are stuck in intensive care. The good news is there is a way forward. Take your loved one out of intensive care and improve their quality of life at home by having highly skilled and professional intensive care nurses come to your home 24 hours a day. We also liaise with the doctors directly 24 hours a day who are overseeing the medical treatment plan, so you don't need to worry about that either. And what about funding? Well, I'm glad you've asked. The cost of an intensive care bed is $5,000 to $6,000 per 24-hour bed day. The cost to be in your own home environment is about 50% or less than that. Therefore, healthcare funding agencies are funding intensive care at home services because it's a win-win situation for everyone. You and your loved one can go home, improve your quality of life. The ICU or pediatric ICU can empty one of their in-demand and highly sought-after ICU or PICU beds, and the funding bodies save 50% or more of the cost. It's a win-win situation. Here is a breakdown in more detail about our service and also some case studies. Go and have a look on our website or just click on the links below the video in the written version of this blog. And if you want to find out how we can help you to get your loved one out of intensive care, including palliative care, we can also help you to get your loved one out of LTAC or long-term acute care or out of a nursing home. Or if you find that you have insufficient support for your loved one at home on a ventilator. If you want to know how to get funding for our service, or if you have any questions, please send me an email to patrick@intensivecareathome.com. That's Patrick just with a K at the end, or call me on one of the numbers on the top of the website. Also, have a look at our career section. We are currently hiring ICU and pediatric ICU nurses for clients in the Melbourne metropolitan area, in the northern suburbs, Mornington Peninsula, and in South Gippsland, Victoria. We are an NDIS, TAC, and DVA approved community service provider in Australia. Also, have a look at our range of full service provisions. We also have been part of the Royal Melbourne Health Accelerator program for innovative healthcare companies. Thank you for tuning into this week's blog. This is Patrick Hutzel from Intensive Care at Home, and I'll see you again next week in another update.